This is History Network News. We interrupt this program with important information. I am Rachel Finneran, reporting to you live from Newburyport, Massachusetts. It is January 1st, 1831, and this just in. William Lloyd Garrison breaks news again in his newspaper, The Liberator. He tells the public that he will be heard. For everyone who doesn't know, William Lloyd Garrison was born on December 12, 1805, here in Newburyport, Massachusetts. He was the son of immigrants from the British colony of New Brunswick in present-day Canada. Garrison is an American abolitionist who later had a major part in supporting the women's suffrage movement. He is also an activist, journalist, publisher, and a social reformer. He is very well known for controlling this abolitionist newspaper called The Liberator, which he founded and published in Massachusetts this year, 1831, until slavery was abolished by a constitutional amendment after the Civil War. Prior to that, he was one of the founders of the American Anti-Slavery Society. He doesn't believe in slavery and believes that everyone deserves to be free. When Garrison was 25 years old, he joined an anti-slavery movement. For some time, Garrison was a part of an organization that promoted the resettlement of free blacks to a territory on the west coast of Africa called the American Colonization Society. In 1831, this year, Garrison moved back to New England, where he and his friend Isaac Knapp were founders of this weekly anti-slavery newspaper we call The Liberator. A major quote from William Lloyd Garrison in The Liberator is to the public, published today, January 1st, 1831, was this. I am aware that many object to the severity of my language, but is there not cause of severity? I will be as harsh as truth, as uncompromising as justice. On this subject, I do not wish to think or speak or write with moderation. No, no. Tell a man whose house is on fire to give a moderate alarm. Tell him to moderately rescue his wife from the hands of the ravisher. Tell the mother to gradually extricate her babe from the fire into which it has fallen. But urge me not to use moderation in a cause like the present. I am in earnest. I will not equivocate. I will not excuse. I will not retreat a single inch. And I will be heard. The apathy of the people is enough to make every statue leap from its pedestal and to hasten the resurrection of the dead. That is all the news we have for today. This is Rachel Finneran. Everyone have a nice day.